Joining us now is Russell Begaye, the Navajo Nation president, and Sonny Skyhawk. He's an actor, producer, and founder of the American Indians in Film and Television. Nice to have both of you gentlemen here with us. President Begaye, I want to start with you. You were in the room yesterday when President Trump used the term Pocahontas with the code talkers. What was your response?
Well, first of all, this was a day when the code talkers were being honored. They're war heroes. They helped and put an end to the war. We are enjoying freedom today as it is because of their work, because of what they did, their sacrifices. Some of them did not return. Some of those that were there with us in the Oval Office yesterday, they were injured there on the islands when they were during the campaign. And so this was a day to honor them. And to insert something like that, the word Pocahontas as a jab to a senator, you know, that belongs on a campaign trail. That doesn't belong in the room when our war heroes are being honored. And that was really a good gesture by the president, by the White House, to be able to bring our co-talkers into the Oval Office. It has not happened before. Mm-hmm. But then to be able and to insert that in there, I thought it was just uncalled for. And we need to honor these war heroes, our American war heroes, in a respectful way, in any situation, in any circumstance, in any environment. And this was a good environment for Americans to say, thank you, code talkers, Navajos, you use your language, you've done this, you really built this nation to what it is, you were part of the successful war during those years. And so we honor you, we thank you for what you've
done.
So
you thought it was unnecessary. You thought that
it was unnecessary.
And do you see it as an ethnic slur?
I feel that the way it was used, yes, it was, because now Pocahontas is a real person. It's not a caricature. It's not something that's just made up, a person. But this is a person, a young lady, and a Native American woman that played a critical role in the life of this nation.
So was a hero.
And to use that person in that way, you know, is unnecessary and it's being culturally insensitive.
And Sonny, what did you think when you heard about it?
I agree, first of all, with Mr. Begaye, and good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I thought the whole thing was staged. The fact that Andrew Jackson appeared in the back of the room.
What about that? Sonny, I wanted to ask you about that, because that portrait of Andrew Jackson that hung in the back, did you see that as a deliberate slight?
I definitely do, and I think every other Native person that knows who Andrew Jackson was believes the same thing. Mr. Trump has been in television enough, and he knows the staging. He knows how and what people are going to see. And I think it was a condescending racial slur that he delivered, and unfortunately at an inopportune time when these heroes were being honored. It's uncalled for, totally uncalled for, and he knew what he was doing. And
you think he does know the history of Andrew Jackson and the Trail of Tears?
Pardon me?
You think that President Trump does know the history of Andrew Jackson?
Of course he knows Andrew Jackson. I think Andrew Jackson is one of his heroes. He acts like him, he talks like him, he wants to be him in modern day. But again, it was totally uncalled for in regards to mentioning Pocahontas in this setting, especially in the fact that it had nothing to do with this gathering. This is all about honoring the co-talkers, and rightly so.
Sonny, one more question. Please. I read that you said that you want Americans to know the proud history of Native Americans and their service to this country. And you say that the Native people of America have voluntarily served with honor by per capita in larger numbers than any other race in America. In every conflict in defense of this country, we did not stoop to claim spurs in our feet. Can you expound
exactly
on that?
I stand by that statement. Our people have served bravely and honorably in just about every conflict that the United States has ever had, in numbers, in total numbers, including the code talkers. And of course, the Navajo code talkers were not the only code talkers. We had other nations that were represented by code talkers. So again, to slur the history of the code talkers or any service person, is totally uncalled for.
Mr.
He knew exactly what he was doing.
Mr. Begaye, in our remaining seconds, what do you want from the president? Do you want an apology?
Well, I would like for the president to first continue honoring the co-talkers, our veterans, and he needs to stand by the armed forces, by our veterans, especially war heroes that really made a huge contribution to this country, to the freedom that we enjoy. And he needs to just put it in his mind, in his head, that these are American war heroes. And when you're in the midst of great heroes, you need to respect them and leave everything else aside and just honor them and thank them. And this is what we, that's who we are as Americans, is that we thank each other, especially in defense of freedom of this great nation. And for Native Americans, this is our land. Every inch of it, every mountain, every stream, every water that is out there, it is ours. It's a Native American country. That's why we will defend it all the way, because we have no other place to go. This America is Indian country. And this, and so every non-Indian out there is a guest of Native Americans in this country. And that's how they should act. And if you're a guest in this nation, that's how you should act, especially if when you're in the middle of, in the midst of these war heroes. And so I ask the president to respect our people, to respect our heritage, to respect who we are as Native Americans, especially war heroes.
Well, President Russell Begaye of Navajo Nation and Sonny Skyhawk, founder of American Indians in Film and Television, thank you very much for sharing your perspective.
Thank you very much.